Greetings, fellow things. Welcome back to Blackthorne. The next level that we're going to be tackling is, well, the desert level. Apparently, we've been told by Seer Onehand to look for the Grave of Thoros. She did not give us any specifics. She told us that we will know when we found the grave, when the time is right, whatever that means. Well, she's a seer. She is wise in her ways. So, let's hope she's wise enough. Without further ado, let's go ahead and begin this then. Another cutscene. I wish the cutscenes had some variance to them, you know? Not just the same thing over and over again. Reporting as ordered, sire. Release the stone beasts and do not return until the son of Vlaros is destroyed. And he points to them as an order. I'm dying to combat. I'm basically dying to combat is what's going on. Because these guys don't cock anymore. These hide right after. So timing it to where you can hit them is pretty difficult. That went smoother than I expected, but yeah. Doesn't mean at all it's going to go that way. Okay, I think I'm getting a hang of this. I can't explain it yet, but I think I'm getting a hang of this. Flawless, if I say so myself. Thus far, at least. Okay, for the next section, we need a bridge key. It's very nearby, very close to the bridge key. I mean, this you can actually see a bridge being operated in the background over there. So what we do here, there's nothing on the drawbridge on the left, by the way. What we do here is we jump down, turn around, deploy the firebombs, jump down here, operate this, and just casually walk past it. No need to run. So this thing, the first one, is a rock beast. And it essentially rolls at you like that. Killing them is pretty easy, they are not really challenging to be honest. And that's dead. It'll give us a hover bomb that we can use. Actually, that gives us the bridge key. Yeah, so the way to tell these pillars apart from rock beasts is also pretty easy. We're gonna take a running jump there and run through all the way to the end. Climb up this side. Not that we technically need to, but this guy's gonna give us a hover bomb, so might as well. Excuse me there. I'm not even gonna try jumping the gap here. I'm just gonna, well, essentially jump straight upwards. Yeah, it's safer. It's just far safer. So in the next section, I'll tell you guys how you can determine which one is a rock beast and which one is not. Okay, so there are like quite a few enemies up ahead. There's like a middle section. There's a rock beast underneath. There's a middle section and a top section with only one enemy. Middle section has got like two enemies. Okay, time to focus. The key, I think, lies in the sound. Last shot rings sort of hollow, so that's your cue to shoot. Doesn't always work though, of course. Yeah, I was trying to do something there. Okay, let me try help. Oh yeah, that is actually a path that we can take. Interesting. I was thinking the first time around, that seems like the mountain is pretty distant, but It seems right inside of a range. And, well, what do you know? It's right here. Oh, okay, there are two of these guys. At least the one underneath is not a rock beast. Wonder why I came here, though. Nope, that did not work. I thought that might work, but apparently it did not. Got it there. Okay, come on. One of them said. We can't exactly hold the fire button and expect them to walk into it. Yep, look. They've got like this armor for that second there. Lost 2 hit points because of that. Oh well, I don't think we're gonna lose anymore though. Okay, come on. One shot and done. Varying your shots, I see. Almost. Need to be faster. Come on. Oh, come on. Thank you. Now, what did I get from you guys? One of them is a firebomb and the other is also a firebomb. Let's try jumping down there just to see if there's anything worth grabbing. That is not a rock beast, so I'm confident in not eliminating it. I wonder if there's anything down here. Nothing. We just came here for two of these firebombs. That's it. Nothing else. Cool then. So, we go back then. So, I just want to quickly show you guys what rock beasts look like. Jump across. Cool. And at this point, I'm just going to drop down. And there are two more here. So, I just came here to show you guys how rock beasts differ from the others. So if you can see, there are like four pillars here. The second one from the left, that's a rock beast. How you can tell is because the reflections on it are shinier. And the dirt surrounding the bottom, that's also like shinier. Yeah, pretty much what I was trying to do anyway. Alright, let's head down there. Since those enemies are more or less optional, I'm not gonna tussle with them. That takes care of them. Let's climb back up here. There's no way for us to jump the gap or at least try climbing up there. So yeah, if the reflection on a pillar is shiny, that's a rock beast. Oh, a caulking guy. You guys are easy. I like you guys. I don't think there's a trap of any sort for this section here. More firebombs for these plants, most likely. And yeah, so if the dirt underneath the rock thing is shiny, that's a rock beast. Be careful. Was there anything up there though? I don't remember seeing anything. Oh yeah, there was like a ladder to get up there, I do believe. Only a ladder, that's it. Right. Climbing back up. There's no way for us to actually run and bridge the gap, so this is the path that we must follow. Probably should have hidden away there. Yeah, my bad. Totally my bad. Should not have taken this two of them for granted. I tried jumping, but I had my gun equipped, which was essentially what my mistake was. That That is not a rock beast. That one is a rock beast. So I'm just gonna pull my gun out, cross it, and wait for it to weaken. Good job, son. Hide. They only take 4 shots to die, so that's good, I suppose. In a manner of speaking. Now the question is, how do we get back there? We could like try hanging on this ledge. Nope, I can't see what's down there, so I'm not gonna jump down. Like, we could probably be safe jumping down here. Actually, no, I would rather not. Okay, let's get a running jump here. Time to jump this gap. We don't typically need to, because I suppose if even if we fall down, we'll be just fine over there, but yeah. Alright, cool. We got the key that we needed. This level is comparatively more linear than the last. Or maybe I'm just playing it that way. Okay, pulling a gun out. That's another rock beast. Okay, running through it. I don't know if that guy, that thing is gonna come all the way here, but yeah, I don't see the point to beating it. Or maybe that has something, who knows. Maybe it has something. Do you want to beat it? These guys only activate at like very certain intervals. Too close for comfort there. So as long as you're standing under it, it's not gonna crush you. The gate, I mean. I don't know whether it takes a health point or not, but it's not gonna crush you as long as you're standing underneath it. We got a hover bomb. Don't really know what we could use that for, but yeah, we got a hover bomb. Trapdoors are always two-directional. Let's hang here for a second and see what's down there. There is another path there. Let's go down there first. Let's use this bomb here. Cool. I just want to quickly jump across it and then blow this thing up, because I feel like it might just be a trap. Cool. Now to jump upstairs. Excuse me there. I guess, oh no. Be careful, son. You need to make the jump. There's no other option for you. If you fall again, you're dead. And you're gonna have to retry all of this again. All over again, I mean. Yeah, that was pretty much what we had to do. And this is the part to the next level. Alright, seems pretty linear thus far, and I suppose in the desert you can't really ask for anything else either. Okay, next level then. Okay, the first place that we need to go is upstairs. We'll get to that section later. Item number 4, I almost got to the end, but then I sort of died. Oh, right. I made a very basic error, is what I made. During my last run through, I mean. That's a firebomb, we'll require that for later. We'll be going down there later first, we need to conquer this side. Don't worry about going to the right, you won't need to go there. Excuse me. This guy's holding out now. Like holding in the open once he's done firing. Which is why I'm able to get so many shots off on him. I'm gonna move towards him, equip my gun and wait again. Alright, come on. Almost. Who's laughing now, bitch? Not you, that's who. So, we can actually... We should be going to the right, in fact. A broad jump will suffice. And that thing there is a rock monster. The guy at the bottom gives us a bridge key, which we need. Through this door, I mean. Okay, next. This thing's like an armadillo. Once it has its shell up, there's no beating him. This is another rock monster, which is not going to bother us for now. On our way back though, it will bother us. We dropped right behind this rock monster here. But I don't think the rock monster comes all the way here. It actually does, what do you know? Looks like we're gonna have to face off afterwards. Or maybe we could do it just now. Is that all you got? Just a bit of defense? No offensive capabilities then, I take it. Excuse me there. I think this key will help you. Please take it. That's a bridge key. We do require that. Climbing back up. Jumping through the section here. Funnily enough, that guy did not wake up this time around. It doesn't really matter actually, we're done with that side, so yeah, we need to go upstairs right now. Do another broad jump right here, and then jump the gap right here, use the bridge key. I don't know why I hear somebody like cocking their shotgun there, but yeah. First we need to talk to this guy here. You must be the chosen one, please take this potion. Thank you, friend. Yes. And once that is done, we go upstairs. Equip and hide. Let him bloat. Put some lead in his belly. I can't tell if these guys are muscular or they're just fat. I think they're pretty muscular, to be honest. Oh, come on. I'm getting sloppy. That's my bad. Alright, focus. Time to focus. Too slow. Okay, he's dead. Now, up ahead, we'll meet a friend and a rock team. Now, the friend is impervious to the rock team, but we need to watch our shots, otherwise we can hit this guy. We're going to get a levitator from him, which is going to be useful up ahead. And just so that a friend remains unharassed or unmolested by the rock demon, we'll go ahead and take the rock demon out. But we need to be careful one shot at a time. too many shots and a stray bullet can hit our friend here. Oh yeah, this rock demon also dropped something. I forgot what it is, but I think it's a bomb? No, it's a key. Yes, we do need this iron key, actually. We need it right up ahead. There's also an enemy to the right, but I forgot what he drops, though. I think it's just a random firebomb. Do I want to jump this gap? I don't think I do. Because I feel like we've got whatever we need right here. Yeah, just do another broad jump here. Another one here. And yeah, we'll take this ladder back downstairs. And we're gonna casually walk over these things to deactivate them. Turn around, select the firebomb. Probably should have come down here and done that. Because now we're in need of health. Luckily we have some. Now before I step on that plate which unlocks the door up ahead, I'm gonna go back here and negotiate with the spider for this extra potion right here. Because every bit of health counts. Jump. Cool. Jump up, run through the door, and that's it. Climb down this face. Now up ahead we have another trap. And what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna pull my gun out and hide away. Let's hope that we don't hurt ourselves doing this. Right. Excuse me there. We have this thing, but I'm not certain whether this is like a trap or not. This is actually not a trap. Oh, it is. Well, that is my bad. Come on then. At least I'm in a safe spot right now. By safe spot, I mean a place where this guy can't get me. And eat me off the roof whenever he pleases. And I'm being a little liberal with the combat because I've got health potions. Probably should not be as liberal with the combat and with my own life at that, but yeah. I am being a little liberal with the combat right now. So for this next section, we're just gonna walk over these casually because we want them to drop. And then we're gonna drop down here. And yeah, we're gonna come down here. There's really not much here. So what we want to do is, first we want to go in here and talk to our friend. He has health potions for us. Like two more potions. Thanks for the help. Maybe you can use this potion. Thank you, friend. Actually, we have not helped you yet. We will, though, pretty soon. Don't worry about that. So for this section, I just want to take my shotgun out. I see the rock demon is up again. Up and rolling again, I see. Hide. I'm just going to stand right here at the corner. I don't know how many shots is hitting him. Okay, done. I don't think he drops anything. But even if it does, I don't really think we need to pick it up. Well, it's a firebomb, so okay, fine. We're gonna need that for the next section, I believe. Okay, so going up there. This is not a rock demon. We're gonna drop a firebomb down there, and hopefully it works. And this is the little levitator that we need to use to climb up there. And come on, we need to be faster. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Okay, we're safe. Two rock demons here, but I don't know how many of them are actually gonna activate for us. That is just a trap. That is just like a lever. Pressure sensor for the same one, same door. I mean, that we need to tackle. All right. Come on then. He said. And I don't think this one's gonna toggle anytime soon, but yeah. We just wanna use this here and jump up there. Climb up the ladder. Climbing the corporate ladder there. Use this key right here. Grab whatever that is. It's another health potion. Since we have so many, might as well use one. And then we come down here. And there's gonna be an enemy here, and behind him will be... Motherfucker. Yeah, this is what I wanna do. Hide. I could just avoid him altogether and enter the door, but it's okay. Die, bitch. I'm gonna hide in the doorway. That makes most sense. Most cover from enemy bullets there. Excuse me there. Okay, this guy's getting on my nerves. I have the health, so might as well, I think, beat and hit. Okay, he's dead. I wonder what he has though. Just a firebomb. Maybe we can find some use for it. I don't know. But yeah, at any rate, I don't think we can make the jump. Just a simple broad jump. So I'll try to, yeah, do a running jump instead. And we don't want to fall down at all. So this is what we want to do. Oh yeah. We need to head down here. Use the firebomb. I'll just pop one of these in. I don't think we need to, but I'll just go ahead and do it nonetheless. Be careful not to use the hover bomb, because I feel like we'll need to use it up ahead. Oh yeah, this section. It's like a total bait and switch sort of section. Well, I got both of them at least. Fuck you guys. Okay, he's dead. So this next section, the developer's intent is pretty much obvious. Once you get past the section, don't think about going back, because that's a pretty lengthy, pretty lengthy section of unstable footing over there. I'm gonna go ahead and use that again. Alright, so up ahead there are gonna be some spider bots, so you might want to be a little careful. Yeah, right there. Broad jumping through spider bombs just to get whatever this is. It's a hover bomb, in case you used one already. So yeah. This level starts off with a nice little gift for you. There's a blue guy right behind that boulder thing. That rock monster, rock team, whatever else you call it. This game in particular is quite difficult. Like this level. Because it just gets you double teamed against, like the enemies double team you, essentially. Is what makes it so difficult. Oh yeah, we need to eliminate those things. And then this thing is gonna come to life. Shot the afterwards. You might want to hide when it does that. Done. So not only does this level have multiple instances of, well, dual enemies, but a lot of times these enemies are flanking you on either side, making this section incredibly difficult. So the way I've found to deal with them is to just wait for the person who shoots last. And go after them. I slipped there. Like it was a slip up, not that I actually slipped. Now with that being done, it's actually much easier to shoot these guys now. Time to hide again. He said, time to do like a broad jump. Get a firebomb and another firebomb. Hold up. Not what I wanted to. Sorry, my bad. And this next section, we need to. Thought as much. Yeah, we basically need to jump across. And the controls are really precise. I don't know if Prince of Persia had controls this precise, but. Yeah, it's really precise, and you don't jump when you, just when you hit the button. You'll jump when the jump animation kicks in. So, boy. Now, there are some pickups down there which I would like to pick up, but for now, I'm just gonna ignore all that and just head straight through to the other side. And secure my footing right here. I'll pick up the stuff on the way back instead. This is thingy, you don't need, really need to pick it up. Like, interact with it, I mean. What I'm gonna do instead though is pick this up. And up ahead is where the game tests you again. When you need to eliminate two of these guys. First, I'm gonna focus on this one. Pretty much why I wanted to go there. Now, even if this guy can hit me, I do not have. that guy's dead. Now we can hide away and consume a potion. Good. As long as my back is to the wall, I can take them on, I feel like. That guy's dead as well. Now, you might be thinking that you don't need to take this guy out, but I could not. You would be wrong, essentially. Because you're gonna come back from here. Come back through this way, I mean. Come on then. I'm waiting for you. So the last time around that I made a mistake. A strategic error. Probably because of a lack of intelligence. And when I say intelligence, I do not mean my IQ, but rather information about what I'm doing. Which led me to make like a pretty big blunder up ahead. So yeah, first we want to take out this wasp. There's no point to hiding behind it, but yeah, you can see how weak the shotgun is. It literally takes like, I don't know, 10, 9 hits onto the wasp to kill it. Won't you die for me? Now before I head up there, we do need the wasp bombs from him. But before I head up there, I would just like to pick up another potion, because it is fundamental. Excuse me there. Now for this guy, I would like to climb up here. Hide. Too late. I'm trying to play as stealthily as possible, or rather, as conservatively as possible. I'm gonna preserve as many of these potions as I can. I'm gonna need them a bit. Next up, we climb up here. There's a way to get to that guy who's standing up there. But for now, yeah. Let's try jumping across. This like... How? You're dead now. Good thing I got armor there. Yeah, so now it's like a 1v1 fight, which is a good thing. Come on then. Missed. I think that was 7 shots in total. Come on. I'm waiting on you. You're dead as well. Now, I'm gonna pop in a potion right now. And I'll keep a potion reserve for later. Excuse me there. That could not have gone any worse. Really. That really could not have gone in worse. But at the same time, I can now at least get rid of these weeds right here. So you do have like a brief moment of opportunity to shoot them when they turn. I'm mostly waiting for them to finish like 5 shots, and that's the sign that you can actually shoot them. Long shots essentially. Or when they walk, in this condition where I missed it. Cool. We don't really need these two. But yeah. There's nothing much, we just need to jump down. But as soon as we get to the top, we are going to be faced with a huge ass challenge. Because there are two guys on either side of us and both of them are flanking us. So, good thing that I kept this ready, I suppose. Because the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to run right past him. And time to heal. Like, we need to make sure to heal properly. Okay, fine. That's done. And the only reason we have come here is to beat the rock demon in the next segment. Do not want to lose health there, but yeah, excuse me, just give me a second there. Now, the reason I went to the right and not the left is because if you go to the left, then this guy essentially entraps you. You better shell up as soon as you see that guy turning into a rock again. And he leaves us a nice parting gift of a bridge key. Excuse me there. Now we go back down. And we essentially backtrack. And don't worry, you don't need to like do a broad jump or anything right here. You just follow the path. That's it. Just follow the path and you're all set. Now this section is where you need to be a little precise, because if you fail, you'll be falling to your death. And we come out right back here is pretty much the entire reason why I took this guy out, otherwise I'd been avoiding him all this while. Like, no need to get into a firefight that you have no business getting into, right? I don't think I need to get to him, so I'll just run right past him. No, here's what I want to do. I want to jump over to this side here. Use this. Get some health potions for myself. And a key, which I can definitely use. And yes, it might seem like we're stuck here. We're actually not. Did not mean to do that, but oh well. It's fine. So we basically need to make this jump, but not perfectly. Which I sort of missed. I found this key. You can have it. Thank you, friend. So this guy gives us like a spare key to use. Which lets us go through this door. And it enables us to come out at the very foothills of the very place where we began, where it all began. So this thing is going to come alive as right now, so I'm just going to run past it, because I've got no interest in fighting it. It does not drop anything. It's just a waste of time. Not of resources, but just of time. Time that I could spend using it somewhere else. So what I do want to do first is I want to go up there. I'm gonna walk over these because it doesn't really take much effort to jump across the gap there. And I'm gonna use one of these wasp bombs to destroy this thing. And now I'm gonna head towards the right. What I'm expecting to happen up ahead is I'll probably get into like this random section where I die for no fault of mine, just because I didn't know this game well enough. And yeah, those sections do occur quite often in this game. There have been multiple instances where I've had to restart like an entire level from the beginning, from right near the end, because well, something did not work out the way it was supposed to. Alright, moving on. I've got another key. I've got no idea why I've got that key, but I do have that key. Now, I don't really know if I have to tackle that guy or not, but I do want to tackle him nonetheless. Hide. In the nick of time. Hit in the nick of time. Shot him. What's strange is that once you shoot them, they get like this sort of temporary armor. Come on. I don't want to die to you, of all things. Come on. Excuse me there. I'm peeking out too early is what my issue is. Firefights in this game are pretty long drawn. Nothing new there. If only I had better skills. I guess the game finally decided to give it to me. The victory, I mean. We've got another key here. Now, I don't know if that rock demon holds anything of value or not, but it would seem we have reached the end of the level regardless. Okay, now this level is getting on my nerves at this point in time. Primarily because of how long it is. First we take this guy out, and then well, I don't know what to do after that. Actually, I do. I just... I'm bored out of my mind. Item number 8 after getting through huge chunks of this level. So, yeah. Forgive my frustration. But you will find it to be rather justified. Especially once you get to see the length of this damn level. This guy gives us a new gun. Which he will use to bring an end to one of his friends upstairs. This gun is just like the previous one, but it fires explosive rounds. So it takes... It's twice as efficient, meaning it takes 3 hits instead of 6 to down your opponent. Cutting the length of firefights in half, making life easy for everybody involved. Now up ahead we can go one of many ways, but just for the sake of variety and in case I die soon, I'm just gonna go ahead and take the path on the right near the entrance first. I'm gonna let this guy hit me, and every time that he does, he's gonna gloat, and that is gonna, yeah, expose him. I did not mean to do that, but well, whatever, it worked. I'm gonna leave it as is, and I'm gonna head this way. Platforming sections, which are absolutely lethal. Right. Jumping down first. Because why not? Hide. Thank you for waiting for me. Not shooting me in the back as soon as you saw that exposed and me unarmed. That was pretty sloppy shooting on my part. He said he will grant us another firebomb that is definitely going to be useful for us. Well, I feel that section. Excuse me there. Our fates are going to be pretty similar in this section up ahead as well, should we choose to fail it. Not that we can choose to fail it, just that we can fail it. You're dead, almost. And I'm almost dead as well. So here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna run past this section. No need to fight those guys. They are just a drain of your on your resources. And I'm gonna drop down to this ledge right here, turn around, equip the firebomb and use it. That is a health potion. I'm gonna pick it up and I'm gonna use it immediately. Time to shoot this bug dead. Excuse me. We're gonna fight this guy now. If I'd had my gun drawn, I could have gotten two shots off on him. For free. But here we are. Standing by like a fool. I should probably move a step closer, yeah. That way I can exploit his gloat response, as I like to call it, where I shoot him dead while gloats. Come on. That's one way to do it, I suppose. Now be careful not to fall down there. This is a lethal fall. No matter how much health you have, you will die. I've died to this section multiple times now. Being why I'm warning you guys about it. And then there's this section. The only grunt that we need to actually bother ourselves with is the last one. The one that's down there. The rest are just fillers. In a scheme that you shall never understand. Too late. Too soon. But that got me two shots on you, so I'm happy with that. For now. Come on. He's dead. And he drops a key that we can definitely utilize. And I'm just gonna come here, jump up here, avoid those guys essentially. And then, oh yeah, right. Lots of dangerous platforming sections in this level. Things that are sure to leave you dead. This key will come in handy later. First, we need to take the path that heads right near the top. Actually, it's the middle section to be honest. Avoid this guy and just head your way. Jump this gap like a scene man. Take the route below instead of the route up top. Or you could just do that. I can't believe I failed this section twice. And live to tell the tale. But oh well. Okay. So now we need to go up. And hang right. Walk past these ladders. Just casually stroll past them, no need to get all bent up and aggressive. So up ahead, there are a few ways we can go about this. We can drop a firebomb downstairs, or we can just trade in like a health point. I'm more or less saving the firebomb for later, but well, you're gonna have to trade in a point of your health either way. I'm just gonna ignore that guy, wait for this guy instead. Move ahead. Oh, you thought you could copy me, huh? I'm not gonna let this slide. I'm not going to let your little indiscretion slide. That guy exploding actually hurts you. I'm gonna let that trapdoor go for now because I wanna get these wasps from this guy first. And that essentially gives us a key to the puzzle. These exploding wasps here. We need to kill him for that though. Excuse me. Too slow. Come on. That was piss poor shooting on my part, but at least I got two hits on him. Nope. Very poor shooting, but at least I will have something to show at the end of it. Because, I mean, we're gonna get a health potion pretty soon. So, the thing behind the pouch behind the trapdoor is essentially a health potion, and we're gonna get it right now. Oh, come on! Don't make this harder than it has to be. I'm just gonna stand under here, let this door collapse on my head, so that I have a space, I have the time and space to get back out. And that's it. We are just gonna walk past this guy as if he's none of our business. Because he actually is not. He really isn't any of our business. Right, moving on. Excuse me there. Jump across here. A lot of moving through different parts of the level and a lot of backtracking for just this one singular level. We'll be going back up there shortly, but first we need to head to the left here. And use not only our fire bombs, but also our wasp to good effect. Right. So like I said, this it's just a matter of where you choose to devote a health point. You can either do it here or you can do it back there. But yeah, there's nothing on the left, don't worry about that. Excuse me. We just jump down here and then we jump down here as well. Also that we can trigger this elevator call mechanism so that we can go up to scale the entire thing, the entire mountain, all the way back to the top, just so that we can ride back down here. Gee, I wonder if there was something like a shotgun that shot exploding shots to just punch a hole through the damn floor instead. But oh well. The worst part of this level is the most difficult part of it is yet to come. So yeah. Hooray! We're gonna get there soon. We're gonna get there real soon. For me at least, it is the most difficult part. Alright, we're almost near the end. Actually, we're pretty far from the end of this one, but yeah, you get the point. Up ahead, we'll need to eliminate not one, but two rock beasts. Three rock beasts, actually. And only one of them holds what we need, and that is a damn levitator. The problem with the levitator is that you can hardly see it. Do I want to go ahead and pop it in just now? I'm not sure. Let me go ahead and hide. Too slow. I was trying to turn, but oh well. These guys are dead, and they don't really drop anything either. Next hit, I'm gonna... Okay, yeah. There's like this huge input lag, wherein this guy doesn't want to hide all the time. So the rock beast actually dropped something right where you were standing. It's right next to the tree, but just barely visible. Great game design, isn't it? So good news is, there are no more enemies for a while now. No further enemies that we need to encounter. But the section up ahead is going to be a test of your platforming skills. And for me personally, of my patience, because up ahead is a section where I've died for the last 4 times. Motherfucker. I always used to wonder why Samuel L. Jackson curses so much. Now I know. Now I goddamn know. Actually, he curses because it helps him not to stutter. He has a stuttering issue, and cursing, especially saying motherfucker, helps him not stutter. So this is where we use the key. So before I use the key, let me show you where we need to get. This is the place where we need to get. And the key to activate this exact trapdoor is placed on the very other end of the goddamn map. It requires a lot of focus. Since I do not accidentally want to use some of the other odd kind of key, I'm just gonna... Yeah. Sloppy on my part there, but at least I had some leeway. So for this, you do not really need to jump across. Excuse me. Alright, we need to focus now. Up. Whew, made it. I'm surprised. Holy shit. It's the first time I've made it this far. I think I'm gonna save the footage right here. I wish I could save the game right there, but I'll settle for saving the footage there instead. And now, where are we headed now? Oh yes, to the part to the left and then to the right. And this is the point of the game till which I've played. I have got no idea what lies ahead. So we need to focus. Yeah, it's just this tour. I don't know where this tour is gonna bring us out, so. Hide. More of them. Come on. Get past me. Good. And this is where I come out. I just wish I could like have checkpoints in this game, but apparently that's too much to ask for. So I see that I'm gonna have to use the levitator right here. I guess we might as well go ahead and use it. I'm gonna draw my gun out and move ahead. I don't know where to go at this point, but I'll try jumping across. Nope, nothing over there. So I guess downstairs it is. The levitator seems to be responding. Okay, so this is the entire bit where I fell through. God damn it. Okay, that's, I think, the statue of Thoros there, the grave of Thoros.
You'll know when you found it, indeed. Greetings, Kyle. I am the spirit of Thoros, creator of the light and dark stones. Why are you here?
I have been trapped by the power of Sarlacc and the dark stone.
You were sent to me because only here can I give you the strength needed to defeat Sarlacc.
I hope that it will be enough, if not, our world is doomed.
I feel stronger than I ever have before. I am ready to face Sarlacc. Yeah, well, that is quite a lot of health we have got there. And I suppose that brings us to the very final chapter of this game. Thank you so much for watching, thank you so much for tuning in, thank you so much for sticking around until the end. After this, we're going to return with Sarlacc's castle. Until then, take care. Fare thee well, fellow Earthlings. Oh wait, I will send you to where you can search for him. Good luck, Kyle. The fate of two depends upon you.